Now that I've got a new package, it's time for a new pointless video. And this, as you can see, is a giant drive head playmat, which I'm using right now as a wall scroll. I actually got two of them. Also, it has the track on the bottom because you're supposed to use it, I guess, for playing with the drive head toys. Let's see if it works. Okay, we got Backdrift here, and it indeed it barely does fit on the rim, but why not? Scott says there, stop, but, and I don't know what the 40 is for anyway. Okay, so over the first one I had was a medium size map, and this one is a small map. I don't know if they make a large one. This one just has Go On It and Sonic. The other ones had all four of the drivers. It's interesting that they only made them with the first generation drive heads and not the Mark II ones, but I don't know, maybe this didn't sell that well considering I was able to find them for a good price this much later. But anyway, I like them, and they don't make any real drive head posters, at least not that I've ever seen. I know there was like a big wall scroll they were selling, I think, at the TBS store with the movie poster, but other than that, I haven't seen any official ones. Got a big Shinkalion one from like a long time ago, so from a magazine. This is the first long type I've added to my collection, the Fuji-Q Highland Dodonpa. That's a kind of funny name. This is apparently a real life roller coaster though. And this is actually a really neat one because it comes on an actual track and it can move back and forth down the track. And also as it's moving, it kind of, it's hard to do this with, again, with one hand as my usual stick, but it shakes around a little bit. The cars do. So I just think it has a nice sense of realism to it. There's actually tiny people in the cars, you can see. I was surprised this one actually had decals because most of the time I could do not, but they had to put in all the stickers on like the steps and then like this blue pattern on each one. And they were very thin stickers, so it was a little bit annoying to do. Probably would have been fine without the stickers, but that's okay, I just put them on anyway. This one here is a premium, the Lamborghini Gallardo Superleggera. I'm sure again I pronounced that wrong. They always have these weird names for the Lamborghinis. This one is relatively recent, came out earlier this year, and it's the regular color. I believe there was a limited edition one. It's a really nice color. This one is actually, it's similar to the one that was released in the main line last November, but this one is a much, it's actually a paler color and different detailing like on this side. I just, as I've said, I don't get tired of Lamborghinis. They're just, and it's also great to have a premium one because it's just a little bit fancier. It's kind of a shame they don't have any Lamborghinis in the limited vintage line. Maybe someday. Probably in the Neo because the first one only does Japanese cars, but I know they have a, like, I think like Ferraris and things in that one, so who knows. This one is one of the Earthgranner toys. It's the Corgranner Leotomica Terabikun version. It came with a magazine. I don't have much interest in Terabikun because it's mostly about Super Sentai and Kamen Rider, which are not franchises that I follow. But I wanted to get this issue because I just really love this color. It's hard to see in this light, but it's this metallic red. It's the same as the Corgranner Leotomica, but the difference with this one is it doesn't have some of the same features. The original one had a button on the bottom. This one does not. It doesn't make any sounds. It seems like you can still fit it into the devices. I actually attempted that and it works. I'm not sure if it does anything different when you have the The Earth Grace or the Earth Handle. I don't currently have those. I'm not sure if I'm going to get them. But in any case, it doesn't function with the robots themselves. However, I just like the metallic color a lot. So nice to have it in my collection. I also love the fact that it comes in a box. I wasn't really expecting that because it was a magazine insert. But I do love the Tomica boxes for some reason. Even before I collected any of these, I was just kind of fixated on the boxes. This one is one of the ones from the 50th anniversary collection, which is basically re-releases of the original six Tomica from 1970. This one is the Toyota 2000 GT in blue. To be honest, it's definitely my favorite of these. I like the Bluebird also, and the Fair Lady isn't bad. The other ones are too plain, honestly, for my taste. I'm not as Vintage cars are cool, but white cars are always boring, basically. But I really always like the shape of the Toyota 2000 GT. This one, it has, of course, opening side doors, which are great. It looks definitely, if you can tell just from looking at the inside in particular, this is a really old car. Both sides open. It does have on the bottom that it's a 2002 mold, so this seems to be just the same one that's been re-released regularly in the main line. Often has like promotional ones. It's not the 1970 mold though. Lastly, I got the Lamborghini special set, which comes with four different ones. And no, I'm not going to attempt to pronounce these ones, but I'll show you. That orange guy here, which is neat. It's actually a convertible Lamborghini. I do have a couple of orange ones, but definitely not in this model. I really like the shape of this one. Green guy, naturally, is cool. And that's the same one as this guy from the main line. I actually have that one easily accessible from here. And I definitely like the green color better. Of course, I just like green Lamborghinis, but I mean, the orange color looks great too, and I still said I really like the yellow limited edition color. This is just a general, really lovely mold on this one. Good detailing, and it's pretty. The black one is my least favorite. The reason being, it just doesn't stand out at all. It does have this one red stripe in the front. Of course, the Lamborghini logo and the white headlights. It's also another convertible. But the thing is, you just have to squint at it too much to see the details. It's a good shape, but I wish they had gone with a slightly more interesting color. Last is the pink one. And I believe this one is just the same mold as the drive head Lamborghini, which I also have. Yep, they look about the same. That one has the thing on top, the patrol lamp, because it's made to be like the Viper of the drive heads. And it's colored differently, but anyway, it's just this one's a nice, bright, loud color. I think if you drive a Lamborghini, you gotta get a loud color. Don't get a black one.